Dear students, welcome to the module on lists. In our earlier modules, we explored about basic Python control structure, decision making statements, etc. Here in this module, our focus is on a commonly used data structures called list. The most basic data structure in Python is the sequence. Each element of a sequence is assigned a number, its position or index. The first index is 0 and the second index is 1 and so forth. Python has 6 built-in types of sequences, but the most common ones are lists and tuples, which we would see in this module. There are certain things you can do with all sequence types. These operations include indexing, slicing, adding, multiplying and checking for membership. In addition, Python has built-in functions for finding the length of a sequence and for finding its largest and smallest elements. Now coming to Python lists. The list is a most versatile data type available in Python, which can be written as a list of comma-separated values called items between square brackets. Important thing about a list is that items in a list need not be of the same type. Creating a list is as simple as putting different comma separated values between square brackets. For example, here in this slide, you can see that different ways of creating lists. I have created 3 lists. List 1 is a set of items where the physics is the first item, chemistry is the second item, 1997 is the third item, 2000 is the fourth item. Physics and chemistry, they are string type, whereas 1997 and 2000, they are numbers. In list 2, all items are numbers separated by comma. In list 3, we have 4 items, that is 4 characters separated by comma. Similar to string indices, list indices also start at 0 and list can be sliced, concatenated and so forth. Accessing values in a list. To access values in list, use the square bracket for slicing along with the index or the indices to obtain value available at that index. For example, we can see that how elements are accessed in from different lists. Here you see list 1 is the elements of list 1 are the physics, chemistry, 1997 and 2000, and list 2 is the members are numbers from 1 to 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Just print the list 1 of square bracket 0. So, when you print list 1 with an index value 0, what is the output? The output is physics, that is the first element. And in the second print statement, print list 2, wherein we print 1:5, that represents the index value. 1 represents the second index, because in list the index starts from 0. So, 1 refers to the second index and up to the fifth index. So, list 2, 1:5. So, what is the output? The output is starts from 2, 3, 4, 5. So, here this actually it is from the starting from the index 1 and it goes up to what we have specified here minus 1. Actually, it is when I specified 5, it goes up to 5 minus 1, that is 4, that is from 1 to 4. That is at location 1, we have 2, at location 2, we have 3 and so on up to 5. In Python, list is a mutable object. That is, we can change the state and the content of a list. Please remember that in Python, objects like tuple and strings are immutable. That is, you cannot modify or change the content. How do you update a list? You can update single or multiple elements of list by giving the slice on the left hand side of the assignment operator, and you can add to the elements in a list with the append method. For example, so here you see we create a list with elements physics, chemistry, 1997 and 2000. Now we print the value of the list at index 2. At index 2 we have, so physics is at 0, chemistry is at 1, and at 2 we have 1997, and what we get is the output is 1997 when we print the element at index value 2 in the list. Next we try to change the element at index 2. So here you see we assign list of 2, that is when I say of, I mean put 2 between the square brackets equal to 2001. Now the element which was at index 2 initially is 1997, now that is changed to 2001, and then again I print the new and the value of the list at index value 2. Now I get the output as 2001. So this is how we can update the list using the index value. Okay. If you know where to insert an element or where to update an element using the index value, we can use this method. Otherwise, we can use the methods that we are going to see as we go along. Now, how do you delete list elements? To remove a list element, you can use either the del statement if you know exactly which elements you are deleting on the, or the remove method if you do not know. For example, we see the example of deleting lists elements from the list. Here again we use the same old list which has the elements physics, chemistry, 1997 and 2000. We print the list, so at the output you can see that the elements are printed as physics, chemistry, 1997 and 2000. Then we delete, we use the del statement del list one of 2, and that is 2 is the index value. The index value 2 now refers to the element which is at index value 2, that is in our case it is 1997. And after deleting the element, then again we print the list. Now you see that the item 1997 is no longer there in the list. Let us have a look at the basic list operations. List respond to the plus and asterisk, that is a multiplication operator, much like strings. They mean concatenation and repetition respectively. Here too, except that the result is a new list and not a string. And in this table, you can see the various Python expressions along with the results and the description. So the Python expression, the first row of the table, I use the function len. So these are the basic operations, len, len, and I give a list as an argument, and I get the number of elements in that particular list. So that is 3. So I give len of 1, 2, 3, a list which is whose elements are 1, 2, 3. I get the result as 3. The number of elements in the list is 3. Then just I use two lists. One list is 1, 2, 3. The other list is 4, 5, 6. I use the plus operator that actually puts both the lists together, and I get a single list with elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this refers to concatenation. Plus operator here acts as concatenating the list together. In the third row, you find a list with a single element high, a string, and I put a multiplication operator, that is asterisk 4, and finally what I get as output is I get a list with 4 highs. So that means it is repetition, asterisk represents repetition. Now the membership function in, so I check 3 in 1, 2, 3. I give a list and I ask whether 3 in 1, 2, 3, I get the answer as true, That means 3 is a member of the list. So, checking for membership. And in the last, there is a 5th row, you find we can iterate through elements in a list as we have already seen when we have visited the for loop control structures. For x is a variable, for x in a list, we are given a list with elements 1, 2, 3 and we simply print the value of x. And what we get at the output is, we get all the elements printed out at the output, that is 1, 2 and 3. That is iterating through a list using a repetition structure like for. Now, let us try our hands on the indexing and slicing in lists. Because lists are sequences, indexing and slicing work the same way for lists as they do for strings. In this table, you can see the common operations that we can do using for indexing, slicing of lists. Here, for an example, I have created a list with 3 items, spam, 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 the same word, but the first item is all lowercase, second item, the first letter is capital, and the third, all letters are capital, to illustrate the indexing and slicing operations. The first operation is getting the item that is located at index value 2. Here 2 refers to the index, and since our list contains only 3 elements, so the index starts at 0. So, 0, 1, 2. So, 2 refers to the last element, that is spam in all caps. Now, what happens when you give a negative value as an index? For example, in the second operation, I have given L of minus 2. Now, here what is minus 2 refers to? Minus 2 refers to the index from the end of the list. So, minus 1 refers to the last element of the list. Therefore, minus 2 refers to the last but one element on the list. So, I get the output as spam with S capital and other letters in lower case. The third, I give L of 1 colon. Now, what is this colon? So, the first one refers to the first element that I want. 1 is the first index. First index is this actually the second item, because the index starts from 0. So, the when 1 refers to the second element. And what is colon? Colon is the rest other elements after that. When I put a colon, I mean all other elements. Okay. So, it is 1 till the end of the list. So, I get 1 at location 1, I have that second element. So, from the second element to the last element, all gets printed out. Okay. So, this operation is called slicing. And we using slicing, I can make sections of the list. Now, let us try out each and every built-in functions and methods in Python that manipulates a list. There are built-in functions in Python that perform functions like comparing elements of lists, two lists, finding the length of the list, finding the maximum element of a list, finding the minimum element from the list, converting a tuple or any other sequence to a list. Program code, a sample Python code I have shown, wherein I have compared, I use the compare function. In Python, the compare function is implemented using the CMP function. So, now for that purpose, I create 2 lists, list 1 and list 2, with elements 1, 2, 3, x, y, z in list 1 and 4, 5, 6, a, b, c in list 2. And then I say print compare list 1, comma list 2. So, what does it do? So, here the compare functions compares elements of the list, both the list from list 1 and list 2. Numbers are compared and similarly strings are also compared. And when I compare list 1 to list 2, I find that the number 1, 2, 3 is less than 4, 5, 6 and therefore, I get minus 1 as output. And similarly, here when I compare list 2 to list 1, now I see I get a plus 1 as output, because list 2 has 4, 5, 6, so which is greater than 1, 2, 3. And now I create a new list by adding a number 786 to list 2. So, list 2 already has 456 and ABC. So, along with that it has one more item 786. Now, I compare list 2 and list 3. Now, tell me what will happen? When I compare list 2 and list 3, list 2 has 2 elements 456 and ABC, but whereas list 3 has elements 786, 456 and ABC. So, therefore, the element 786 is greater than 456. So, I get now minus 1. Clear? Here this slide explains the list max function of the list. So, how do I get, suppose you have a list of numbers or list of items, how do I get the maximum element from the list? Okay. Now, I create a list 1 and list 2. For example, list 2 consists of elements 456, 700 and 200. Now, what is the maximum element of this list 2? 456, 700 and 200. The maximum element is 700. So, I get, so when I pass list 2 to the max function, I get the value 700 as the answer. That is the maximum value of the element in my list 2. Similarly, the min function. So, here again I use the min function with the same list, list 2. Now, you see there are 3 values 456, 700 and 200. Now, the minimum element is returned. So, min of list 2 is going to be 200. Here I am going to use the list method. So, what is this list method? So, as I already told you before that there are 2 types of objects in Python, immutable objects and mutable objects. Immutable objects are those objects that cannot be modified, the content cannot be changed. Whereas, mutable objects are those objects whose content can be changed, that is, you can insert elements, delete elements, update elements. Under this type, list is a mutable object wherein we can add elements or delete elements. But whereas, a tuple, which we will see later, is not a mutable, it is immutable element. Therefore, suppose there is, now the Python has given a facility for us to convert a tuple to a list. So, now in this Python code, you will see that you have a tuple, create a tuple with elements 1, 2, 3, x, y, z, Zara and ABC, some strings. And what we do is, we convert that tuple, we call the list function, list, and pass on this tuple as an argument. So, this tuple is converted to a list using the list function. Now, I can store the value of the list in another variable called alist, and now use alist as a list. That is, I can now add elements or delete elements from this alist, but that I cannot do on that tuple. Now, comes the methods for the object list in Python for performing various operations on the list. So, what we saw initially was the functions which operate on list. Now, we are going to see the methods available in list. In slide number 12, you see a Python method called append. So, this method, when I say method, what is a method? Method is a member function of a object. So, list comes with a method called append, and this append method adds a value to the existing list. For example, in our example, we have a list called a list with elements 1, 2, 3, x, y, z, Zara and ABC. There are 4 elements. Now, I use the list, I call this variable a list. I use a list dot append. I use the dot operator and call the function append, because append is the method of a list. So, I can call it a list dot append, and to that I pass an argument 2009. So, I am trying to add a new item 2009 to the list of already 4 elements. Now, I print the list, updated list again. Now, I find that this value 2009 is appended to the end of the list, and as you see on the output. Now, the list contains 5 elements. In this Python code, the next method in the list object, that is count. This count method counts the number of elements of a particular type. For example, if I create a list called A list with elements 1, 2, 3, X, Y, Z, Zara, A, B, C and 1, 2, 3. So, 1, 2, 3, there are 2 elements. Remember, list can have duplicates. So, there are 2 elements which are duplicates. Say, for example, 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3 are repeated. Now, I say print count for 1, 2, 3. Now, you want to know how many times this 1, 2, 3 occurs in my list. So, print count for 1, 2, 3. I simply say a list dot count, I pass the item name, that is 1, 2, 3, and you see how many times it occurs? 2 times. So, answer is 2. Now, I say count for Zara, how many times the text Zara is there in my list? It is occurring only once. So, a list dot count of Zara returns the answer 1. So, now you understand what is count returns. Count returns the number of times or the frequency of items that occur in a list. The extend method of a list extends the list, that is adds another list to the current list. Here in this example, you find we have created a list called A list with 5 elements as we have seen before, the same 1, 2, 3, X, Y, Z, Zara, A, B, C and 1, 2, 3. B list 2 elements 2009 and money. So, there are 2 elements in B list. Now, what I do is from A list, I say A list dot extend. I call the method extend, A list dot extend and pass B list as an argument to extend. And what happens to A list? Now, I print the A list. When I print the A list, I find that the B list is appended or extended at the end of the A list. Now, A list has how many elements? Initially, it had 5. Now, it has 7 elements. Okay? So, the elements from B list, that is 2009 and money, are appended to the list A list, as you can see in the answer. Here, this code demonstrates the use of the index method. Index is again another method of the list object. So, here it returns the place or the index where a particular item resides. For example, here I say A list is equal to the same list I have used 1, 2, 3, X, Y, Z, Zara and A, B, C. There are 4 elements. Then I say index of X, Y, Z. I want to know at which location in the list is X, Y, Z available. I simply say A list dot index. I use the index method A list dot index. I pass on the variable X, Y, Z, item name X, Y, Z and the answer I get is 2 because X, Y, Z is the second element. X, Y, Z is the second element that is in my list. So, the answer is 1 because the index starts from 0. So, the second element is at location 1. And similarly, what is the index for Zara? Zara is the third element in the list. So, since index starts from 0, so the third element will be available at 0, 1 and 2. So, the answer what I get for Zara is 2. What if you have that element at different duplicates at different locations? If you have elements, same element at different locations, we get the minimum index, the first index where that particular element is available. Then list method, that is insert method. So, here I can insert a new item anywhere inside the list. What is the difference between then insert and append? Append always adds a new item to the end of the list, but whereas insert will insert the new item wherever you locate it. For example, if I want to put an element at location or at index 2, I can insert a new element at insert at element 2. So, here I create a A list with elements 1, 2, 3, XYZ, Zara and ABC. Then what I do is I use A list dot insert at location 3. I have to tell the index value 3. 3 is what, which element? 3 is 0, 1, 2, 3. That is at the fourth location. I want to insert at the fourth location 2009. So, you know that in the original A list at fourth location, you have ABC. Now, what will happen is 2009 will be inserted at the place of ABC and ABC will be at the fifth location. So, that is what you can see in the result. The remove method. So, list has another method remove, just like insert and append adds elements to the list, remove methods removes the element from the list. Okay. Now, here again I have list, the same list, A list with 5 elements. Now, I say remove XYZ. Okay. Now, I say remove XYZ. So, what happens is, just carefully observe this code. There are actually 5 elements 1, 2, 3, XYZ, Zara, ABC, XYZ. Please note that XYZ is repeated twice. It is available at index 1, it is also available at index 4. So, since there are 5 elements. So, at index 1 and 4, this XYZ is available. Now, when I say remove XYZ, which XYZ will be removed? So, the XYZ that is going to be removed will be the first one, the one that occurs before. Here, you see the answer, the XYZ which is at location 1 has been removed. So, the remove method takes the name of the item to be removed. Okay. And when I say remove ABC, ABC occurs only once. So, that there is no ambiguity in that. So, the item ABC is removed from the list. Reverse method. The reverse method simply reverses the order of the elements which are there in the list. So, you know the A list which already has the elements in this order. First comes 1, 2, 3, second is XYZ, third is Zara, fourth is ABC and fifth is again XYZ. Now, when I say A list dot reverse, then what happens? The list is reversed from right to left, that now XYZ which is the last element now becomes the first element, the ABC which was the last but one now becomes the second element, so on, and the first element 1, 2, 3 goes to the last. So, this is the function of the reverse method. Sort method. So, list has a method called sort. So, which sorts the elements in order, alphabetical order or numerical order. So, here you have a list called A list with elements 1, 2, 3, the same A list we have. And what we do is, we say A list dot sort. Now, you see when you print the A list, you see numbers come before. So, you have 1, 2, 3, you have only one number, so that is there, but you have 4 text or strings XYZ, Zara, ABC and XYZ. So, they are alphabetically sorted, ABC comes first, XYZ and XYZ comes later and Zara since starts with Z goes to the end. So, so the sort method sorts the list in a Python. The pop method. Pop method is also similar to a remove method, but except the change is that the pop method always removes the last element of the list. Okay. Say from now I have a list with elements 1, 2, 3, XYZ, Zara and ABC. Now, when I say simply say A list dot pop, the last element is popped out. What is the last element? ABC. When I now what I can do is I can use pop element with an index value also, say 2. When I say pop 2, so, whatever element is at location index 2, that is also popped out. That is at index 2, 2 is 0, 1, 2, the third place. The third place we have string Zara and Zara is also popped out. Okay. So, you get the output as Zara. Now that we have come to the end of the module, we will have a quick recap of what we have explored on the list. Remember, list is a collection which is ordered and changeable. List allows duplicate members. So, to summarize, we discussed on list how to create and use list. The various operations performed on the list have been also explained. In the next module, will be another data structure called tuples. Hope you have enjoyed this session on list. Please try more examples hands-on to understand more about list. Goodbye till we meet again.